Welcome to the today's lecture. Today we are going to discuss waterlogging, its causes, effects and remedial measures. So let us start. So what is waterlogging? When the conditions are so created that the crop root zone gets deprived of proper aeration due to the presence of excessive moisture or water content, the tract is said to be waterlogged. To create such conditions, it is not always necessary that under groundwater table should enter the crop root zone. Sometimes, even if water table is below the root zone depth, the capillary water zone may extend in the root zone depth and makes the air circulation impossible by filling the pores in the soil. The waterlogging may be defined as rendering the soil unproductive and infertile due to excessive moisture and creation of anaerobic conditions. The phenomenon of waterlogging can be understood with the help of a hydrologic equation, which states that inflow is equal to outflow minus I minus storage. Here, inflow represents that amount of water which enters the subsoil in various processes. That means the total amount of water which is flowing, entering into the subsoil. It includes seepage from canals, infiltration of rainwater, percolation from irrigated fields and subsoil flow. Thus, although it is a loss, it represents the amount of water flowing through the soil, total inflow. Many times water logging subjects to salinity of soil. Salinity means what? Presence of salt. Soil salinity is the salt content in the soil. The process of increasing the salt content is known as salinization. Salts occur naturally with soil and water. Salination can be caused by natural processes such as mineral weathering or by gradual withdrawal of an ocean. It can also come about through artificial processes such as irrigation. Salinity from irrigation can occur over time whenever irrigation occurs, since almost all water, even natural water, contains some dissolved salts. When the plants use this water, the salts are left behind in the soil and eventually begin to accumulate. So, since soil salinity makes it more difficult for plants to absorb soil moisture, these salts must be leached out of the plant root zone by applying additional water. This water in excess of plant need is called the leaching fraction. Salination from irrigation water is also greatly increased by poor drainage and use of saline water for irrigation agricultural crops. So, salinity of any soil increases with respect to time due to other prevailing conditions, such as if the water is stagnant for more number of days, more duration, and if excess water is being supplied to the plants, then plants will try to extract only water, and whichever the salts are present in the soil, they will remain as the residue into the soil, and in due course of the time, these salts accumulate over the period of time, and soil gets saline. Then what are the causes of waterlogging? There are n number of causes of waterlogging, out of which we will discuss few, like inadequate surface drainage. If drainage is not proper, then eventually there will be waterlogging. When the surface drainage is not adequate, the heavy precipitation in the area is not drained off quickly and the rainwater remains stagnant over the area for considerable time. This gives rise to heavy percolation and water table rises in that area, which increases waterlogging phenomena. Then over-irrigation of the soil. When the irrigation water applied to the field is in excess of the requirement of the crop, deep percolation takes place which is retained in the intermediate zone, augmenting the groundwater storage. So it is also not, it should be avoidable over irrigation. If the water farmers they are getting more frequently the water and more quantity of water, then it is a common tendency of the farmers to fetch more and more water. But until and unless it is necessary, it is advisable not to use excessive irrigation, as it will somehow it will result in water logging and further increasing in the salinity of the soil and decreasing the yield of the crops. Then obstruction of the nature drainage. If the nature drainage is obstructed by irrigation channel, rail, road embankments, it will not be able to pass the rainwater of the catchment. There will thus be flooding of land and consequent water logging. So any obstruction in the nature drainage will increase the water logging phenomena. Then obliteration of natural drainage. Sometimes the cultivators plow up and obliterate an existing natural drainage. This results in the stoppage of stormwater flow, consequent flooding and water logging. If earlier there are some ditches, nalas, if they are plowed and that particular area it is being used, then there is no scope of the water to escape, and ultimately the chances of flooding and water logging are more in that area. Then what are the effects of water logging? Salinity is one of them. There are several effects of water logging which reduces the yield of crop, and further they should be avoidable. Out of them, first one is the inhibiting activity of soil bacteria. The liberation of plant food is dependent on the activity of soil bacteria, which requires adequate amount of oxygen in the air for proper functioning. There are a number of bacteria present in the root zone. As of now, you might have studied Azotobacter, and there are a number of bacteria, Nitrosomonas bacteria, which liberates nitrogen, which converts the air nitrogen into the nitrogen which is consumable by the plant. All these bacteria help the plant to grow, to get their nutrients. If the activity of these bacteria it is affected, then ultimately it will have the effect on the productivity, yield of the crop. So when the soil pores within the root zone of crop normally grown are so saturated as to effectively cut off the normal circulation of air, the land is said to be waterlogged. And this waterlogging affects the activity of bacteria, which requires adequate amount of oxygen. If waterlogging it is there, then there will be no circulation of air, no amount of more amount of oxygen will be there, and there will be no activity of soil bacteria, and ultimately the yield of the crop will be affected. Then decrease in the availability of capillary water. Plant life draws its substance from the soil solution around the soil particles, which is drawn into the plants by capillary action and osmosis. Though there is ample of water present in the root zone, but soil moisture and capillary action are the important factors. Due to capillary action, only the roots will extract the water, the moisture and the nutrients. So if the capillary water it is not available in the prerequisite amount, then also it will affect the yield of the crop. If the water table is high, the roots of the plants are confirmed to the top layers of the soil above the water table. While if the water table is lower, the root of plants have more room for their growth. So sometimes it is better to have the water table at a lower level so that the plants will have the ample of room for their roots to grow and to extract the capillary water and nutrients desired. So third is the fall in the soil temperature. A waterlogged soil warms up slowly, and due to lower temperature, the action of soil bacteria is sluggish and plant food available is less. So decreasing temperature will affect the activity of bacteria, and ultimately it will affect the yield of the crop. Then defective air circulation. When the water table is high, the drainage becomes impossible, and the carbon dioxide liberated by the plant root cannot be dissolved and taken away. Consequently, fresh air containing oxygen is not drawn and effect activity of soil bacteria and plant growth suffers. So it is also one of the parameter. Then what are the preventive measures? What are the measures to avoid this water logging? First is controlling the loss of water due to seepage from the canals. The seepage loss may be reduced by adopting various measures, for example, by lowering the FSL of the canal. Loss may be due to percolation or absorption, but when the FSL is lowered, the loss is reduced to sufficient extent. It is, of course, essential to see that while lowering the FSL, command is not sacrificed. Even if you lower the FSL, there should be adequate water available to cater the need of the commanded area. Then second is by lining the canal section. When the canal section is made fairly watertight by providing lining, the seepage loss is reduced to quite a good extent. Then by introducing intercepting drains. They are generally constructed parallel to the canal. They give exceptionally good result for the reach where the canal runs in high embankments. So these drains are essential for draining the excess water, the flood water, and generally they are constructed parallel to the canal. Then preventing the loss of water due to percolation from the field channels and the fields. The percolation loss can be removed by using water more economically. It may also be affected by keeping intensity of irrigation low. Then only small portion of the irrigable tract is flooded, and consequently the percolation loss takes place only on the limited area. It keeps the water table sufficiently low. So if you are irrigating your farm very precisely, economically, and if you are irrigating a particular tract with sufficient water, then only that portion of land or the farm, that tract will be flooded, and consequently percolation losses will be less. So there will be no rise in the water table, and ultimately there will be no water logging. Then augmentation of outflow and prevention of inflow. It may be accomplished by introducing artificial open and underground drainage grid. It may also be achieved by improving the flow conditions of the existing natural drainage. So you have to avoid the excess inflow, and you have to make sure that the outflow, it is drained properly. Then quick disposal of rainwater. Quick removal of rainwater by surface or open drains is a very effective method of preventing the rise in water table and consequent water logging of the tract. It is needless to state that the rainwater removed is net reduction in the inflow. So as far as possible, we have to avoid the excess inflow. So it is quite sufficient for this particular lecture. So I hope you have understood what is meant by water logging, what are the ill effects of water logging like salinity, and which measures we can take to avoid the water logging and further its consequences. So if you are having any doubt, you can ask me on my email address dnpaitankarce@sanjeevani.org.in. Thank you for listening. Happy learning.